Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're gonna show you how to fix one of the errors. We did fix it before, but now we come up here to fix it with better solutions and also better explanations. You see what happens here when you try to capture something, then I save it. It throws the error which says fatal error, unquote PDO exception, SQL statement, HY000 general error 1361 field. They give you the field name, does not have a default value in, then it gives you the address where you're gonna find that. Okay, the reason here why is this thing is like MySQL is always being developed to be in strict mode. So once you take out this in strict mode, it simply means you won't get that problem anymore. But then it's not normal to put it, but sometimes you want to bypass this to do what, to get into a simple solution, and then you do what you want to proceed with the code. It's not bad to leave it in strict mode. You have to only to run around and try to see if you can fix the error. There are a couple of solutions. In the first place, you might use, let me look into the table we're messing up with. We look into okay, we're gonna say that industry type. Okay, I'm gonna look for the table. I can't see the table. Let me get the table for you, then I show you. Okay, let me get to understand the table which I'm posting in. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna look for the table. I can go here and just put this. You can run this code, which I might paste here. Okay, you say set global SQL to that. Let me say this. Once we run that code, we might not see that error anymore, but I'm gonna come back to you. You can see the error is gone, but we have another solution and another solution. So that's simple. Sometimes it's advisable to go and do what, and change your mode, the field to not be null, to be null. You get me? Once you make it the field to be null, you see you got some fields here. Those fields which gives you problems, let me see, strict structure, you go to the structure and you make the fields which gives you fields to make them null. Not null, you get me? So that also gonna work. Also, one of the cheapest, easiest solutions we gave you last time was to go to more, click more. Okay, let's click on PHP my admin. Okay guys, if you use the first solution didn't work, second solution didn't work for you, go here and say more, then you click on variables. Once you click there, you're gonna look for SQL mode. If you don't get it, okay, just type in SQL, then you go to down, scroll down. Let me say mode, does it? No, SQL. Well, let's go down. So look, you can see this also. It's called SQL mode. Once you hear, you can click on edit. Once click on edit, this time they don't give us anything, but anyway, in your, I'm using a different what, a different SQL what, they're gonna be a line which said strict mode. So that strict mode, you delete that strict mode or that line. Once you take it out, you're gonna have any, you won't have any problems. So in older MySQL, you're gonna have a chance here to delete what you want to delete. But this, in this MySQL which I have, you cannot delete that. You get me? Another thing is, in older MySQL, you can go in your mysql.cnf, something like that file, then you take out what they call the strict mode. You get me? So in that file can be found somewhere like you go to etc, let me go location, you go here and say look for etc. In etc you can sometimes find here mysql.cnf. You go to MySQL. If you don't see it here, you go to the folder called MySQL under etc. You know, it depends on which version of SQL you're using, MySQL you're using. So I'm looking for that folder called MySQL. You see, you get it. Then you click, you see there are many files like MySQL. You can see MySQL.nfc and the .cnf. In this version, they didn't give us that, but in other versions, they will give us that. Let me go to Google and show you that line, the way it looks like. Google.com, and I say strict. It's gonna be strict mode. It's gonna be MySQL. You can see MySQL strict mode. I think, let's see if we can get something here. In those files, in sometimes you're gonna find something like this. SQL mode, you get me? It's gonna be SQL mode strict something. Let's say error, something like strict mode, like this. You get me? So once you get that in that file, the one we opened, you have to make it not strict. Okay, something also like this. It should look something like this. You get me? Here in your table also, in that page also, you can find the same thing in a place like this I showed you on MySQL here. Here you see, in this place you might find a line like this, looking like this, strict tables, whatever. It's gonna be with a comma. What you're gonna do, you're gonna delete that line. Sweep, don't delete anything else. If you find it's in front of something, there's gonna be a comma before it and a comma after it. Don't delete the comma after it, you delete the comma before it. There could be a comma like this. It's not the only line which is there. There are gonna be many lines there, but what you do, there could be also a comma here. Then there's a video we did which has this version of SQL. You'll find it and you might fix it like this. But this is a temporary solution here. But going into your file like this and find that line and you disable it, it's gonna be a major fix, because it won't do that anymore. So but in this one, once you sometimes install a new database, you might find the same what, the same error. You saw the way we fixed the thing, we just fix it just in simple ways. But now what we're telling you, that there are many ways you can fix it. So by going to this mysqlc.cnf file, if you find it there, you know this is a new SQL, that's why there's nothing like that. So if you're using the older version, you might find that something like that in that whatever in this file. Or you can see here also, you can find that in this, but this time we didn't find it. Once you do that, you're gonna do and then you save. You get me? After clicking that and save, you won't see that error anymore. As you saw that we fixed the error here, we can't see that error anymore. We can create as many as categories as we want, then we're going to see no errors. You can see in the first place we had these errors, but then after the error was just removed by simple code which we presented here. So please guys, don't forget to subscribe. If this video was useful to you, please subscribe and also send us, put a good comment if you have one, and also you can click on that ring which is like a bell, which is gonna notify you whenever we make a new video. Thanks for watching guys, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.